Dave Brubeck. Who was he? Why is he important? What did he do? I'm here to answer all that. My name is Matthew Hanfler, and I am here to answer all your questions about David Brubeck, okay? So, first off, let's just start off with his early life, because his early life is pretty interesting. So, you know, he started off, he was born into the world, like everyone is, December 6th, 1920, in Concord, California. So he was from Cali. He had two older brothers, Howard and Henry, and it just so happened to be that they were professional musicians. Who would have known? And then David Brubeck got lessons from his mother at age 4, piano lessons. Nice and simple, just bloop, there you go. Black and white on the keyboard, baby. And then his father came back and was like, hey guys, we're going to go to a cattle ranch. And so they went to a cattle ranch. And he kind of stopped the private lessons. Oh, what is he going to do now? Well, when he turned 15 years old, he was like, you know what? I kind of like music. So he started playing in bands and pubs and stuff like that. Just dilly-daddling around on the piano. It was pretty fun. He had some, you know, he had some fun and he really liked it. So he was like, you know what? I'm going to go to college and be a vet. And I'm gonna come back and I'm going to help my dad on the cattle farm. All glad and dandy. And then he liked jazz, so he became a music major. Cool. He enlisted in the army and then came back. He went to Mills College to study jazz, and he formed the Dave Brubeck Octet. And then after facing a near-life scuba diving incident, he then formed the more famous Dave Brubeck Quartet. Okay? All right. Now on to the part where I know all of you guys have been waiting for. So we got some of Dave Brubeck's greatest hits. All right, so we got some of my favorites. I'm in a Dancing Mood. Okay, we got Bossa Nova USA. We got Unsquared Dance. We got Blue Rondo a la Turk. And we got, oh, the So Glorious Take 5. Okay, now that we got that out of the way. He was an innovator, a magician of his times. Not really, he was just a musician, and he took some of his musician skills, such as time signatures, and he just went outside the box. A lot of these jazz, it was in 3-4, 4-4, it was in swing. Nice and simple, you could dance to it. Well, he took that and he went out the window. You know what he did? He wrote stuff in 5-4, 7-4, 9-8. He wrote all different types of stuff. And not only did he do that, he also wrote songs that, whoop, switch time signatures in the middle. So, you don't even know what's going on. It's all just about here, man. It was pretty good, pretty fun. Dave Brubeck himself played piano, and one of his more famous albums is called Time Out, which featured every single one of his songs in a different time signature, such as the one that I stated before, 5-4, 7-4, 9-8, stuff like that. And then some of the songs, they go from that time signature and then switch to a more basic 4-4 groove while still keeping that oh-so-elegant sax in there. And now, what all of you guys have been wondering, what is my personal opinions of these songs? I love all of his songs that he's made. I listen to not every single one of them, but I've listened to most of his famous stuff. And let me tell you, man, Joe Morello, when he was playing set on those songs, it is just so spicy. It's so just... Anyways, I love them. I love them all. Love the rhythm section. Obviously, one of my favorites, Take 5 right here. Okay, we have... First off, it starts off with set coming in with this so elegant and beautiful 5-4 groove. It is one of the best that I've ever heard in 5-4. Take a listen. And what that did is it took the simple 4-4 groove and it just added a beat. That's all 5-4 is. So It took 5-4, and it made it enjoyable for the popular audience, right? Musicians out there, they listen to 5-4 and they go, that's odd, but it's musical. When you show this to the normal person, they're like, that's odd, I don't like it. But people love this stuff. They loved it. They love listening to it. And that's why he was an innovator of his time, because he took odd time signatures and the people loved it. He went against the grain. Take 5 is one of the most famous examples of this. We have the song Unsquared Dance, which is in 7-4. He wanted, the idea of it was to create a more Western style. So what he had was, it began with clapping and it began with bass, and it gave not more of a jazz approach to it. It gave more of a home style Western type of an approach. And we have the drums playing on the rims. Very interesting, but very good at the same time. Very short song in comparison with the other songs. It's only around 2 minutes. And then there's a drum solo in the middle of everything. And it's all played on the rims. Very wonderful. Very well done. And a little sneak peek that I'll put in there is that at the end, you can hear him laughing. And, you know, it's probably because of the sick drum group. And then we also have Blue Rondo a la Turk, which is a 9-8 and then switches to 4-4 and goes between those two time signatures. The drums play this sick accent on the 9-8 pattern on the ride, which gives everyone a nice bass to go off of. The sax fills in the space, just little bits. And then throughout the song, it switches to a 4-4 groove with the sax soloing throughout the entire space. And then after that 4-4 groove comes another 4-4 section where the piano section, they solo. So good. So good. All these time signatures, they all innovate and they all feel flow. It doesn't feel forced. It's 4-4, you could dance to it, you know? But this stuff you could also dance to, which was mind-boggling, because this is some weird time signatures. Dave Brubeck knew what he was doing, too. He wasn't some dumbo that was like, oh, I'm just going to write whatever I want because it's cool. He did that, but he also knew that it went against the grain, and he wanted to be an innovator of his time. Plus, he was a musician. He did this for a living, and he wanted to apply this to his songs. He just didn't want to be another one of those, you know, jazz performers that wrote a 4-4. I love all these songs. I love them to death. And the reason why I love them is because they changed music forever. They went from a basic 4-4 jazz or 3-4 jazz, swing, whatever, and they changed it up. They took what was there and they elongated it. They did some cool jazz, odd time signatures, and they made everyone love it. And they made a bank off of it. He influenced music in that time, but also was an innovator of his time and made popular music, you know, that was in odd time signatures, that had flow of music, an innovative rhythm section that not only had important accented parts, but also kept the groove. And Dave Brubeck and the Dave Brubeck Quartet helped progress jazz as the main music